Hi everyone. In this video, today we are going to learn how to issue multiple airlines ticket with interline agreement. Before we go ahead, we must know what is interline agreement. So basically, it's an agreement between the two or more than two airlines. When they agree to issue a single ticket for multiple airlines, this is called interline agreement. So whenever you are going to issue any ticket with a different airlines, you have to check whether they have an agreement or not. So how to check? The command is basically, it's a DT, means display table. IAT stands for interline agreement table, and then DIS, display for Air India. Once you enter this command, you will see these are the airlines, they have a agreement with Air India. So if you move down, I'm going to check a Singapore Airlines, because I am going to issue ticket for Singapore Airlines. So you need to move down to check whether they have an agreement or not. Okay, look at here. SQ is the basically Singapore Airlines. So what we have to do, we can issue ticket with Air India with Singapore Airways. I am going to take a sector from Delhi to Sydney, where I will issue ticket for both Air India as Singapore Airlines. So the first thing is that we have to check the availability between Delhi to Sydney. Okay. Here you can check, we have a connection with the Delhi, Singapore, Singapore, Sydney with the same airlines. But as my topic is to issue multiple airlines ticket, so here I am taking line number 10, line number 11 and 12. I'm taking a Delhi, Singapore with Air India. And from Singapore to Sydney, I'm taking Singapore Airlines flight number 211. Okay, so I'm going to pick a seat for one passenger from line number 11 and line number 12. Okay, I'm going to seal seat. Need one seat. I'm taking a Y class, line number 10, sorry, 11. And again, Y class, line number 12. You can see, I have booked the ticket from Delhi to Singapore and Singapore to Delhi. You can check, I have a different airlines. Okay, half of the sector I'm traveling with the Air India and half of the sector I'm traveling with the Singapore Airways. Okay, I'm going to return after 10 days. So I'm taking 25th of September. Okay, we need to check carefully. So you can check, this connection is available on line number 3 and line number 4. Sydney to Singapore and then Singapore to Delhi. Okay, need one seat in a Yankee class, line number 3. And again, Yankee class, line number 4. Okay, so you can check all these itinerary. Air India connection with the Singapore Airways. Again, Singapore connection with the Air India. You are traveling Delhi to Singapore, Singapore to Sydney. And then Sydney to Singapore, Singapore to Delhi. Okay, now I'm going to enter the name of the passenger. Suppose the passenger name is Sharma, okay, and his name is Prakash. Okay, now I'm going to enter the phone number of the passenger. Okay, then I'm going to issue ticket immediately. T dot T star. I'm going to file a fare. I'm going to check a lowest fare for this sector. Use FQBB to find the lowest fare. Okay, I got a fare of 3,90,000 rupees. Okay, I can rebook. The system is telling me to rebook the fare is FQBBK. Use this command to rebook the fare. And the fare, the system is suggesting me to, you should book the ticket between Air India and Singapore in Nancy class. Okay, successfully I have booked the ticket. Now, you have to enter the TMU, ticket modifier update, line number 1, form of payment, cash, commission percentage 0, okay, then R.P, P for passenger, save the PNR and reopen the PNR. You can check, I have successfully saved the PNR, okay, and I have stored the ticket. Now I am going to issue the ticket. The command is TKPDTD, okay. You can see successfully I have issued the ticket. Now open the PNR again. And you can see in this PNR, I have sold the seat for Air India as well as the Singapore Airlines. Now I'm going to open a ticket, electronic ticket, asterisk HTE. You can see here, the status is open. And you can see I'm traveling from Delhi to Singapore on Air India. Okay, again, I'm traveling from Singapore to Sydney again on Singapore Airways. And the fare basis is YIATA2AI. So you can see this is called bilateral agreement between the airline. This is interline agreement. This interline agreement enable you to issue the ticket for multiple airlines. Now, what are the benefits for the passenger? Benefit number one, when you issue a single ticket, the passenger will submit the ticket at the Delhi airport. He will submit the baggage at Delhi airport and he will collect the baggage at Singapore Sydney airport. He need not to recheck in again Singapore airport. So this is the benefit. Second benefit for the passenger, he will have a single ticket. He will not have a different ticket. So managing travel documents is very easy. Now for airlines, the benefit is Air India can expand his network up to Sydney with the help of Singapore Airways. So airline can easily enhance their network and they can provide their facility, their services to the passenger. So in the world, most of the airlines, they do the interline agreement. So whenever you are going to issue a ticket with a connecting flight, before issuance of ticket, do check the interline agreement table, then you issue the ticket. Now, point number two, remember, in a non-stop flight, most of the flights, they offer higher fare. But when you price the ticket, price the fare with connecting flight, you will get lower fare. That's all about the interline agreement. I hope you understood all these things. We'll meet again on the next video. That's all. Thank you.